Hello friends, today we will try to measure how much electricity can we generate using a potato. You may have seen on the internet that there are several videos in which they use a potato and insert a charger like this, and then they show something is charging on it. Of course, it is not possible and you should not ever try it. I will also explain why it is impossible. If you have seen my last video, I have used a kit. This is a lemon and salt water battery kit. These are the copper and zinc plates and the wires that we received with this kit. And I demonstrated that we can fill in salt water in these small containers and insert the zinc and copper electrodes in it and then generate DC electricity. In our last experiment, we found that we generated about 4 volts of electricity and the current was 0.1 milliampere or 0.2 milliamperes at the most, and we could light a small LED using it. So actually we could generate DC electricity using the salt water battery kit, but the current was very small. It was only 0.1 milliampere. And if you look at our chargers, even the oldest mobile phone needs about 5 volts and 0.5 ampere of current, whereas the newer mobile phones need about 1 ampere or 2 amperes of current. So compare that with the current that we could generate using this experiment. We get about 0.1 milliampere. 1 ampere is equal to 1000 milliamperes. So that is 10,000 times difference between the generated electricity and the required electricity. So even if you are trying to charge a mobile phone which requires 0.5 amperes of electricity, then we are short of 5000 times. So we are getting only 0.1 milliampere, and the smallest mobile phone requires 500 milliamperes. So it means it is not possible at all to charge mobile phone using the salt water battery or lemon battery or potato battery or banana battery or any other combination. But definitely this experiment generates electricity, and you can connect a small LED and test and actually show that the LED is lighting. So the presence of electricity can be detected in these experiments. So what is novel about a potato? When we are using a salt water battery experiment, the salt water works as an electrolyte and the zinc plate works as a negative electrode and the copper plate works as a positive electrode. So there is a chemical reaction takes place in the salt water, and the negative electrodes generates electrons and the positive electrode is more positively charged, and when we complete the circuit, we connect something to in the circuit, then we detect a flow of electricity. So that is how this battery works. So it is in the presence of an electrolyte, these two metal plates, due to the chemical reaction, generate electricity. But on the internet, when they show that you can charge a mobile phone using the power from a potato, the power does not come from the potato. Potato at the most works like an electrolyte. Definitely, I don't know what in the potato, what chemical in the potato works on the metal plates. But certainly, when you insert a positive and a negative electrode like copper and zinc, there is a chemical process that takes place between the electrodes and the electrolyte, that is the potato, and we will detect a flow of electricity. that will be very small. So I guess we will get around 0.1 milliampere at the most, as in the case of our previous experiment. So actually it is not the power of potato that we can charge anything or we can light a LED, but potato works as an electrolyte, or if you use a banana, the banana will act as an electrolyte, or if you use a lemon, the lemon will work as an electrolyte. Certainly it is an interesting experiment. Children will like to do this experiment. So that is the limitation of this experiment. But never try to insert a charger directly into a potato, because see, to work, to generate electricity, we need two different metals. So in case of our charger, the tips of our charger are the same, they are made of the same material. So it is not possible that the same type of material can create the flow of electrons between them. So even practically it is not possible to generate even the smallest amount of electricity by inserting a charger or inserting a USB cable in this. So that is simply not possible. It is not done. Don't even try it. But I will show you how you can actually create a small amount of electricity using potato in this experiment.